the leader in talk radio on the internet, right here on K98Talk.com.
If you want to work until you keel over, have less of everything in retirement, or give back more of your hard-earned money to the stock market again, then just ignore me. But if you'd like to protect the money you save, receive a steady, predictable retirement income, and enjoy financial security for as long as you live, then listen to this. You can download a free report that reveals the wealth-building secrets Wall Street and the banks don't want you to know. You'll learn how you can get guaranteed growth, safety, and real prosperity without risking your money in the Wall Street casino, and how to get the money you need when you need it, simply by asking for it. This is the best way to have a 100% secure retirement and know your money will last as long as you do. To learn more about this method and to get your free report, go to 29security.com. That's the number 29security.com. 29security.com. Go to 29security.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If you're vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
All right, folks, this is Rick Robinson with you. I want to tell you about some friends of mine from a company called Security Enforcement Specialists. When I ran my security agency for 12 years, I worked with one of these partners on a daily basis. He's been involved in this agency now, and with his other partner, they do have over 30 years of experience in the private security industry. If you own a business and you need someone to keep you or your customers or residents safe, then I highly recommend contacting Security Enforcement Specialists today. Give them a call at 405-703-1796. Again, that's 405-703-1796. Again, tell them Rick from K98 Talk sent you. Like I said, if you need the help, they are here for you. So make sure that you go look them up, check them out, and see what they can do. The wrong way. Welcome to the
place. Welcome to the place. J.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't gonna be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
The Internet will never be the same. You're listening to K98Talk.com.
Good God, y'all.
With any candidate or candidates committee.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the Internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader, the Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome, everybody, and welcome, fellow patriots, and welcome once again to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show. I'm Rick Trader, coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network at WNJC 1360 in Philadelphia and around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM, FM 24/7, a whole bunch of others that we'll talk about a little bit later. And joining me today as my co-host is the Patriot from the Garden, from the Commonwealth of Virginia, the President and CEO of Frontiers of Freedom, my very good friend, George Landreth. George, welcome back to Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
It is always great to be with you, my friend.
Third day in a row, George. Third day in a row.
I tell you, we gotta be careful here. You know,
we're gonna.
It's like, am I stalking you, or are you stalking me? I don't know which.
People are gonna start talking about us.
We gotta stop meeting like this.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Well, George, it's great to have you back with us again. And my friend, what's on your radar screen for today?
Well, lots of interesting things. We've got some great guests coming up, so I want to leave some of those topics for them.
Okay.
But one thing we don't have guests on that I think is interesting is this kind of kerfluffle or this feud going on apparently between Donald Trump and Ted Cruz. This morning, apparently, you know, Ted Cruz held a press conference to respond to the "I'm going to sue you if you stop saying, don't start, stop lying about me and my record and so forth." Mm-hmm. But that in of itself is odd. I mean, Donald Trump seems to feel that he gets to proclaim what the truth is, and then everyone else has to accept it. I mean, if you look at his record is very mixed. He says he's pro-life now, and throughout his life, most of his life, even 6 months ago, he talked about Planned Parenthood doing some good, which is kind of an odd thing for someone who's pro-life to say, since money's fungible. That, you know, the idea that they do some good with us, you know, for people is you know, somewhat problematic, because you give someone $100, they can spend whatever they want to spend it on. But nonetheless, so generally pro-life people don't talk about whatever it is they think good that the Planned Parenthood may be doing, because whatever good that might be is probably outweighed by the millions of abortions that they do. You know, I don't know, but that's, you know, I mean, anyhow, so I just find it odd, though, that so we're having a conversation about where someone's pro-life or not. His credentials are being questioned, the sincerity of them and how truly pro-life he is. And his answer is to say, you're a liar. And it's kind of like, we have video of you saying this stuff. And some of it, admittedly, was, you know, seven, eight, one, I think one of the videos is even as much as 10 years ago. But I remember people giving Mitt Romney a hard time in a debate when he ran for the Senate, which was well before 10 years ago, and he didn't say that he was pro-choice. All he did was say that if you were pro-choice, you don't have a lot to fear from me. And then he pointed out that because Congress, the courts have taken it out of the hands of Congress, all Congress can really do is look at things like public funding and, you know, 24-hour waiting periods and some, you know, things like that. So his point was, you know, as between me and Ted Kennedy, I'll vote a little bit different on three very small issues, but that, you know, that's not a reason to hate me if you're a liberal, because the courts have taken out of our hands. That was taken to mean that he was this big pro-choicer, and it was taken from 10 years ago. These same people now say that it's irrelevant when a guy says, I'm very pro-choice, and I'm for partial birth abortion. Well, and then 6 months ago, or less than 6 months ago, in late August, he's a declared presidential candidate. He's telling us that we should... we don't want to be too mean to Planned Parenthood because they do a lot of good. Ted Cruz points this out. That's all part of the debate. You can come down where you want on that issue, but it's a fair point. And now Ted Cruz, because he points it out, is a liar. I'm totally befuddled by what the word liar means nowadays. Liar evidently means that you say things that I would like not to hear.
George, so, I don't think he...
I've got a relative that's a big Dallas Cowboy fan. Next time he tells me how great the Cowboys are, I'm going to call him a liar. I'm going to say, you liar. Just because, I mean, win-loss records don't matter. I do not want to hear how good the Cowboys are.
Yeah.
And since the word liar means you're telling me things I don't want to hear, that's what I'm going to say.
You're right. Well, George, I don't think we even have to go back 6 months for him to say anything. Didn't, in this last debate, didn't he say something about how Planned Parenthood does some good work? In this last debate, this past
week. He did. No, you're exactly right. It wasn't.
Yeah, I mean, so we don't have to go back 6 months.
Right.
And it's like, okay, so Hitler built the Autobahn through Germany. So does that make him a good guy? I don't think so, George. He built an Autobahn. He built a road. I mean, when you talk about the good that Planned Parenthood goes, one of my Facebook friends tried to defend him by saying that, they give out birth control. Well, George, you can get birth control in any gas station men's room. You can get birth control. And then he tried to talk about pap smears. Oh, my gosh, what woman doesn't go to a doctor for a pap smear? I mean, my gosh, George, it's not like Planned Parenthood, even the legitimate services that they give are irreplaceable.
Right, and Republicans have even suggested that to the extent they defund Planned Parenthood, all the funds that go for things that are legitimate health care issues, they would be more than happy to provide to local clinics around the country, but only to those that are not abortion providers. So in other words, there'd be no diminution in any health care provided, but you would stop funding the abortion mills with taxpayer money, which it used to be that was considered completely obvious. Even the people who are pro-choice agreed that the government didn't have to fund these.
George, my wife right now has a very bad sore throat, and it's right within, I'd say, about 4 miles of my house are about 6 different walk-in clinics that she could go to for her sore throat. And I'm sure within the same radius, there'd be another 6 places where she wanted to get a pap smear she could go to without going to a Planned Parenthood clinic.
Right.
This whole idea is ridiculous. That Planned Parenthood does some good. You know, any good services they do are so duplicated by other services.
And that's why I find the whole idea that we get to call everyone we disagree with a liar. It's one thing, if Ted Cruz says, Donald Trump said that Planned Parenthood does some good, and he said he favored funding them to fund all that good stuff they do. But he admits he's not that fond of, you know, the abortion part of it, but the rest of it he's okay with. If he said that, but that's not true that he said that, then that's a lie. you know, or he said, you know, Donald Trump voted on this way, or Donald Trump did, that's a lie. But when you interpret someone's voting record or their public statements, and you can show them on TV as part of the ad, and then your defense is, well, I've changed my position, that's not a lie, because we don't have to accept that your position change is honest and sincere, because for 60 years of your life, you were pro-choice. And you didn't announce that you were pro-life a year ago or 2 years ago. You announced it recently when you declared for the presidency. So the question is, again, I can't know his heart, but I do have the right to make my decision about how sincere it is.
Mm-hmm.
And you know and I know that we've been fighting these fights for decades, and there was never a time on any important issue where we sat down and said to ourselves, aren't we glad that Donald Trump is one of our allies and he's on our side?
George, we're going to have to go to a break in a minute, but before we do, I want to say four things, and I want you to tell me the candidate that you think this come from. Number one, Bush lied about weapons of mass destruction. Number two, let me finish them all.
Okay.
9/11 was George Bush's fault. Number three, eminent domain is a good thing. Number four, Planned Parenthood does good work. What candidate do you believe George Landreth, and I know the candidate George Landreth didn't say these things, but George Landreth, what candidate do you think said that?
Well, that would be Donald Trump. It would also be Code Pink, the ultra-liberal group. It would be, in fact, they've been tweeting that they agree with Donald Trump entirely on those points. And there are a bunch of these people are so leftist that they even are upset with the Democrats.
Mm-hmm.
So the bottom line is we now have the leading GOP nominee is a person who is now parroting the crazy conspiracy theories of the lunatic left.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about, to me this is not a good development that we're now.
It is not. And this is the guy who's leading in the polls for the Republican nomination. Hey, George, let's get this break out of the way and come back and continue this conversation. But you are listening to Conservative Commandos with George Landreth and Rick Trader, and we're coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network at WNJC 1360 and around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM/FM 24/7. Today's show is being brought to you by the First Amendment, protected by the Second. Don't go away. George and I will be right back.
I really don't care. That's my prerogative. They say I'm messy, but I.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today, the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our Constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vyden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
Why will you be required to show photo ID at the Nevada caucus on February 23rd? To protect the integrity of your vote. Why will nobody be required to show photo ID on November 4th when we pick a president? Because it's the law. You can change this. When you go to the Nevada caucus on Tuesday, February 23rd, sign the Voter ID Initiative at the door. It's simply wrong that your vote can be disenfranchised by anyone without a photo ID on Election Day. Sign the Voter ID Initiative now. Vote for it in November. You can protect your vote with one signature on your way to vote for the president on February 23rd. Security is one of the prime topics this year, so why not secure your vote with one signature? Sign the Voter ID Initiative to be sure your vote counts. The single best way to stop voter fraud is to sign the Voter ID Initiative. One signature starts the process to protect your vote forever in Nevada. Join Sharon Angle and Our Voice Pack. Visit OurVoicePack.com to read the initiative. Let's change this and bring real integrity back to elections.
For by Our Voice Nevada PAC, not affiliated with it or candidates committee.
You can call the Conservative Commandos radio show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando radio show.
Welcome back to Conservative Commandos radio show with George Landreth and Rick Trader. And for rebroadcasts of our shows, check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to leadingedgeradionetwork.com, at 1 p.m., roarradio.net, or at 9 p.m., highplainsdailynews.com. Or you could hear this show and all the shows that are associated with the Conservative Commandos Radio Network here on WNJC 1360 by calling 832-999-1199 on your telephone. You don't need an app. You don't need to download anything. Just remember or write down that number and give it a call, 832-999-1199. Try it right now. And, George, we have a great list of guests lined up for today. Let's get the guests list out of the way, and then we'll move on. We'll continue this conversation. Joining us today at 3:35 will be retired Lieutenant Colonel Dennis B. Haney. He was a program manager, United States Air Force jet fighter, aircraft operations director, flight test director, and combat experience electronic welfare officer with 22 years experience in the United States Air Force. And retired Lieutenant Colonel Haney is joining us to discuss the Veterans Patriot Action Conference, which is going to be taking place in Charleston, South Carolina on the 18th and 19th, which is tomorrow and Friday. So he'll be joining us at 3:35. And George, who will you be speaking with today?
Absolutely. Well, at 4:05, we will open up a dialogue with David French. He's a staff writer at National Review. He's also an attorney. His practice is in constitutional law and the law of armed conflict. And he's a veteran, for example, of the of Operation Iraqi Freedom. And he is a co-author of several interesting books, including most recently a number one New York Times bestseller, The Rise of ISIS, A Threat We Can't Ignore. He's a graduate of Harvard Law School, and he is the past president of the Foundation for Individual Rights in Education, and he's also a former lecturer at Cornell Law School. So he will be joining us to discuss an article that he has written in National Review about the importance of the upcoming Supreme Court battle, the nomination fight and so forth, and he argues that the future of the GOP hangs in the balance. I do not disagree with that. I would just argue that the future of the Republic hangs in the balance, not just the GOP. Both do, independently of each other. But it should be an interesting conversation, and I will enjoy that a great deal. Then coming up at 4:35, we'll have Jeff Duance. He's the editor and publisher of The Lid, and he is a weekly political columnist for the Jewish Star and Truth Revolt. And he has contributed to Breitbart. He's also at HotAir.com and PJ Media's Tattler. He is also a blogger for MCRTV.org, and he's the co-host of Fomenting Freedom on SHR Media. So he has got an article that we're going to discuss, again, the same topic, but he's talking about the hypocrisy of the Democrats in demanding that the GOP allow a vote on Scalia's replacement. It'll be an interesting topic because while it is true the president has the constitutional authority to make a nomination, the Senate has the right to do what's called advise and consent. Mm-hmm. That's the same thing they have to do on treaties. When they have a treaties, they don't have to hold a vote right away. In fact, many times they never hold a vote. They simply yawn and say, this treaty is ridiculous. No. They've done that before. That's why, in this case, Obama didn't call what he did with Iran a treaty. So the idea that the Republicans have to hold hearings or have a vote is simply not true. But it should be a very interesting conversation, and I think our listeners will have a lot more understanding of the constitutional issues, the processes, after we've talked with both Jeff and with David. It should be back-to-back. That should just be perfect.
Indeed, indeed. And I'm the fortunate one, George, because I'm the student for today's show. Hey, George, let's again continue our conversation for the next 2 minutes that we started about Donald Trump. I got to ask you a question because it's a question that I get asked a lot, especially from my Facebook friends. If Donald Trump does end up being the Republican nominee against either Hillary Clinton or Bernie Sanders, or I'll throw in Joe Biden, who will you be voting for?
Well, there's certainly no way I'd be voting for Sanders, Hillary, or Biden. No way whatsoever. I can't do that. So Then the question is do I vote for Trump if he's the nominee, or do I do a write-in or something else, some sort of a protest vote? I've always voted Republican, but more than Republican, I'm a conservative. I have my misgivings about Trump because, I'll be honest, my fear is that he will do to the Republican Party what Obama has done to the Democratic Party. And what I mean by that is if you look around the country, state legislatures have flipped and become overwhelmingly Republican in his 7 years. The House and the Senate have also flipped and become Republican in his 7 years. A lot of races have been turned, and I think that my fear is that Trump will do that to us because I don't see him the way evidently 33% of the voters seem to in the primary. I will allow myself the opportunity to decide whether to support him or not, but if I had to make that decision today, it would be very difficult for me to because I look at him and I see essentially a wolf in sheep's clothing. And so part of me says I can't knowingly vote for that. Someone says, well, he'll be better than Hillary, and that my answer is maybe and maybe not. We don't know. And the problem is everything he does wrong, though, will be done in our name. In other words, when he does something wrong, it will be done in the name of conservatism. And we will take the blame for it, and we'll take the fall for it, and he will be denigrating our brand, and that concerns me. But I will quite frankly have to leave open the possibility of warming and agreeing to support him or vote for him. I felt this way about McCain. I was not really a big McCain supporter. I respect his military service, and there's lots of things about him I admire and respect, but I really wasn't remotely excited about him as our presidential nominee. But I warmed to him finally and decided to...
Well, George, I felt the same way about John McCain. I felt the same way about Mitt Romney. You know, John McCain and Mitt Romney were not nowhere near my first choice, but at least they were Republicans. With this guy, I really don't know. You know what, George? I'll tell you something else I'm not looking for. eight more years or four more years of Donald Trump's mouth. I'm not looking forward to that. I'm not looking forward to him, the way he does business. I'm not looking for him dealing with Vladimir Putin that way, or the Israelis, or anyone else, the way he has been dealing with his Republican opponents. I'm sick of this man already, George. And he isn't even the nominee yet. And with that, George, we do have to take a break, and you are listening to Conservative Commandos with George Landreth and Rick Trader, coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network at WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia, and around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, Talk Stream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM/FM 24/7. Don't go away. On the other side, we're going to be speaking with retired Lieutenant Colonel Dennis B. Haney about the Veterans Patriot Action Conference. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
You've heard Paul Deltz playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. He is also an experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485-904.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bottles Sport Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCSforAutomation.com. That's PCS, the number 4, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Tuesday, February 23rd, the historic Nevada caucus to select the president. You can make history even bigger. Sign the citizen initiatives that will take Nevada in the right direction. First, the voter ID initiative to protect your vote in November. Currently, anyone without identification can vote in Nevada elections. Second, the pupil privacy protection initiative to secure the data that is collected on children at school so that it cannot be released without the parents' permission. And third, the healthcare freedom protection initiative. It's time voters had a chance to end the failed Obamacare exchange in Nevada. One signature on each of these will make this historic day in Nevada even bigger. Sign these initiatives right at the door on your way into the Nevada caucus on Tuesday, the 23rd. Join Sharon Angle and Our Voice Pack. Visit OurVoicePack.com to read the initiatives. It's time to make this happen with your help.
Paid for by Our Voice Nevada Pack, not affiliated with any candidate or candidates committee.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the Internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with George Landreth and yours truly, Rick Trader. And for rebroadcast of our shows, please check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to leadingedgeradionetwork.com, at 1 p.m., roarradio.net, at 9 p.m., highplainsdailynews.com, and you can hear our show and all the shows associated with the Conservative Commandos Radio Network from your telephone by calling 832-999-1199. It's our extreme honor to introduce to our show Lieutenant Colonel Dennis B. Haney, retired. He was a programs manager and a United States Air Force jet fighter, aircraft operations director, flight test director, and combat experienced electronic warfare officer for 22 years. And after retiring from the military, Lieutenant Colonel Haney joined forces with Special Operations Speaks as the operations coordinator, and he's also a member of the Citizens Commission on Benghazi with a very dear friend of ours, Roger Aronoff. But Dennis, welcome to Conservative Commandos Radio Show. It's great to have you with us, and thank you so much for your service to our country.
Thank you very much. I'm looking forward to this. I've heard about Conservative Commandos, and Roger, of course, is a very good friend of mine, as is Alan West, and I'd like to join in with those guys today.
Well, we're grateful that you're with us today. Before we talk about the Veterans Patriot Action Conference, I would like you to tell us a little bit about Special Operations Speaks.
Special Operations Speaks was founded in 2012, spring 2012, by two very well-known, even iconic individuals in the special operations field, Captain Larry Bailey, U.S. Navy SEAL, and he was the commandant of the Bud S. School at Coronado Island, Navy Special Warfare Center Training Center. And Captain Bailey is, the icon that I think of when I think of Navy SEALs. Air Commando, U.S. Air Force Commando, Dick Brower is the other primary former of this group, as is Lieutenant Colonel Ken Benway, Special Forces Ranger, U.S. Army, all retired. And they're the foundation and founding members of Special Operations Speaks. The mission of Special Operations Speaks started out, which is why I got interested in them, is protecting those active duty military who are at the pointy end of the spear from the lies, leaks, and that sort of thing that happened within the intelligence community that put our soldiers at risk.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what we're after, as well as being at the pointy end of the spear to help in all veterans matters. And this is one of those veterans matters at VPAC.
Right. And, of course, VPAC is the Veterans Patriots Action Conference, which is going on February 18th and 19th. That's tomorrow and Friday in Charleston, South Carolina. A lot of things happening in South Carolina this week and this weekend. But tell us a little bit about the Veterans Patriot Action Conference.
You bet. The Veterans Patriots Action Conference is open to not only veterans, but also their spouses, but also any patriotic American, since the word patriot in there.
Mm.
Patriotic Americans that want to help get out the vote, especially the military vote. 6 million American veterans did not vote in 2012, and what the
people wow.
to engage is 4 million of those veterans to get back into the fight. They've dropped out of the fight, and that's not like our military to do that. 4 million and 6 million doesn't really sound like a lot, but boy, it sure makes a difference when their votes are not there, much less not counted.
Well, I have to disagree with you a little bit, Dennis. I think 4 or 6 million votes would swing a whole lot of elections and probably swing them in the right direction.
Sure would have swung Florida when they were voting Chads.
Yes, sure. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yep. Not only that, but also our veterans that are active duty that are trying to get their ballots in on time and for whatever reason they don't get there. I've got a personal experience where that happened to me over in flying a war in Vietnam, over North Vietnam. I was a wild weasel, what we call a bear, electronic warfare officers, too much to say.
Mm-hmm.
So in the wild weasel business, we're called a bear, and that's because you've got to be a trained bear in order to do what it is that the pilot thinks we ought to do, which is to drive right at the heart of the SAM site and find it and kill it. And that's where the very famous Air Force phrase, "You've got to be kidding me." That's misspelled. The K should be an S.
Mm.
"Got to be chasing me" came from. So what happened in my case was I was voting back in the day, 1972, and I got my absentee ballot just fine. I'd registered my home state of record in Washington State, south of Seattle, and got the ballot, filled it out, sent it in, and lo and behold, I get a mailing from the registration desk that says not only did your vote not get in on time, but also because of that, we're canceling your registration.
Jeez.
Yeah, so I took great umbrage to them, went back to them and said, "Hey, you know, I was over there fighting a war, getting shot at and doing some shooting.
Mm-hmm.
Can't you make an exception?" And they said, "Sorry, no exceptions." So that not only is just a vignette.
Oh, but they, you know, I'm sorry to interrupt, but yeah. There was a case not too long ago in Philadelphia where there was people coming out of Graterford Prison with boxes full of absentee ballots. They wanted to make sure those people, that their votes counted, people that actually lost the right to vote, they wanted to make sure those votes counted, but your vote didn't.
Yeah,
in Maryland, they just, by the way, just passed a law that convicted felons are now allowed to vote the day they walk out of jail, even if they still have to pay restitution or if they have, additional requirements in terms of, reporting to you know, to the court or whatever over the course of a few more years, immediately they get to vote again. Apparently it's very important these people vote, but not that important that our soldiers vote.
You bet. And I believe you're talking about the People's Republic of Maryland. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. I do say, thank you for using the official title. I was being informal when I just said Maryland.
Yeah, that's where I live. By golly, that's not...
Hey, Dennis, we have to take a quick break, but could you hold on for just 2 minutes, please? Because we certainly want to bring you back and talk more about the Veterans Patriot Action Conference. Could you hold for us, please?
Yes, sir, sure will.
All right, you are listening to Conservative Commandos with George Landreth and yours truly, Rick Trader, coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network at WNJC 1360 AM in Philadelphia and around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM, FM 24/7. We're speaking with retired Lieutenant Colonel Dennis Behaney about the Veterans Patriot Action Conference happening Thursday and Friday in my favorite city in the world, Charleston, South Carolina. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
Why will you be required to show photo ID at the Nevada caucus on February 23rd? To protect the integrity of your vote. Why will nobody be required to show photo ID on November 4th when we pick a president? Because it's the law. You can change this. When you go to the Nevada caucus on Tuesday, February 23rd, sign the voter ID initiative at the door. It's simply wrong that your vote can be disenfranchised by anyone without a photo ID on election day. Sign the voter ID initiative now. Vote for it in November. You can protect your vote with one signature on your way to vote for the president on February 23rd. Security is one of the prime topics this year, so why not secure your vote with one signature? Sign the voter ID initiative to be sure your vote counts. The single best way to stop voter fraud is to sign the voter ID initiative. One signature starts the process to protect your vote forever in Nevada. Join Sharon Angle and Our Voice Pack. Visit OurVoicePack.com to read the initiative. Let's change this and bring real integrity back to elections.
Paid for by Our Voice Nevada PAC, not affiliated with any candidate or candidates committee.
You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos radio show with George Landreth and Rick Trader. And once again, if you'd like to hear rebroadcasts of our shows, check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com. Or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to leadingedgeradionetwork.com. At 1 p.m., roarradio.net, or at 9 p.m., highplainsdailynews.com. Or you can hear our shows associated with the Conservative Commandos Radio Network by calling 832-999-1199. Our guest this segment is Lieutenant Colonel Dennis B. Haney, U.S. Air Force retired, and we're talking about Veterans Patriot Action Conference, which is taking place at the Embassy Suites in Charleston, South Carolina, on February 18th and 19th. That's tomorrow and Friday. And reading from the press release, this makes so much sense to me, so I'm going to read it directly. Here's why this conference is important. This unique, first-of-a-kind event will focus solely on veterans as key agents for political change. Too often, we have firsthand experience with America's enemies and our forgotten men and women in policy decisions well no longer. Colonel Haney, talk about that.
Yes, that's absolutely the case. That's why VPAC really was formed. It was the genesis was in the minds of Colonel Brower and Lieutenant Colonel Benway. And, you know, it's all for getting out the patriots that are there, intrinsically there with veterans within our republic. And one of the main speakers is going to be Admiral James Ace Lyons, four-star admiral, former commander of the Pacific Fleet. And he's going to talk to that. And he's a very illuminating but also an energizing speaker. I just love to hear the man speak. Also, we've got confirmed Dr. Ben Carson will be there. And we're looking forward to hearing what he has to say. He and I, after my Air Force career, I was 17 years with Johns Hopkins University in one of their engineering divisions. And Dr. Carson and I, of course, he's in the medical side of that with Johns Hopkins. But he
heard
that. Before the break, we talked about voter integrity, really. And Lieutenant Colonel Jay DeLancey, Air Force retired, is going to be talking about his voter integrity project. Mm-hmm. And I've heard that speech by Colonel DeLancey, and it's very illuminating about all of the twists and turns that the ballot will take or not take in order to get into the ballot box and into the count. And he talks about how they don't count. A lot of them don't count, and that's a very illuminating experience to hear that.
Well, you had your own personal story how while you were serving in Vietnam, your ballot didn't count. And if I'm not incorrect, I think I don't know if it was the last presidential election or the one prior to that, where there was a lot of discussions how a lot of veterans' ballots were not going to be counted.
Yes, that was also true of the election prior to that. Well, actually, both in 2008 and 2012, there was an effort, specific effort afoot that we were aware of to disallow or not allow, to slow roll getting the ballots in, especially the ballots, you know, a lot of our military are overseas.
Mm-hmm.
And those ballots getting in, there was a specific effort to make sure they were delayed to the point that they didn't count. They wanted to be sure that they got in, but so they could say, well, all the votes got in, but that does not mean that all the votes got in time to be counted.
Mm.
Specifically, you've got to be really careful about how things are worded. Like Hillary talks about the classified that she's put over her server up to, including above top secret plus special caveats above that. And she specifically states that she did not send anything that was marked classified.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't mean it's not classified. And in the case of Benghazi Bob, the CIA chief of base there, who was the lead government official, specifically told one of the GRS operators that was trying to get everybody else over to the villa where the ambassador was about ready to be killed, murdered, mm-hmm. along with Sean Smith, the IT specialist. And what Benghazi Bob stated to to John Tigan was stand down. Mm. And what Benghazi Bob came out in the Washington Post and said was he did not give the stand down order. And so the word order is very important there. What he did not say was he did not say stand down.
Mm.
That way he, by saying stand down order, he was able to circumvent the fact that he did tell John to stand down.
Mm. Yeah, very interesting. I wanted to also, I went again, reading from your press release, because I think it's very telling. With the rise of ISIS and a world at war, veterans across our nation must begin to organize and mobilize now. Could you talk about that, Colonel Haney, how important that is?
Well, for starters, every military person, one of the things they taught us very early on in my career, especially with respect to those of us who were going to go to combat, and I was on that way before I even knew it, and was that the enemy, that being at the time the former Soviet Union and Russia, to be specific, they would document everything they possibly could. They had people collecting every bit of information about you, and that included all press releases that were about you with your name, that sort of thing. And of course, it was all done manually back then.
Mm-hmm.
They would form a dossier on each American, and specifically when our POWs were captured after getting shot down over North Vietnam, they would pull out what they had as far as the documentation goes on these people, dust it off, gather some more, and then they used it against them.
Mm.
One of the interesting things when I graduated from undergraduate navigator training, having had glasses so I couldn't be a pilot, but the public affairs officer at the base I was at said, "We're here to talk to you about a press release for your local hometown newspaper." And I just looked at him and I said, "Are you crazy?" And he was a young lieutenant, he didn't have any wings at all. So he didn't know any better, and that was his job to do that. And I said, "The moment you put that out in the press, it's going into a file the Russians are going to use, and the Vietnamese are going to use against me if I'm caught or captured."
Wow.
And then he did not understand that. So from the get-go, all of us have got a file on us somewhere of information about us in some form. You know, it's a hit-or-miss, haphazard sort of thing in some cases, but it's out there. There were over 100 military people specifically identified last spring as targets of ISIS, active duty military, pictures of them, pictures of their family, addresses for them, and the ISIS came out and said, "These are targets within the United States, go kill them."
Wow.
And I take that very seriously as a former military. Some of us, the military doesn't leave us just because we take the uniform on. In my case, it was a flight suit.
Right.
They can take me out of the flight suit, but they can take me out of the jet fighter, but they can't take the fighter out of me.
Right.
And that's exactly the way I feel. That's why I'm doing what I can for SOS and for the Citizens Commission on Benghazi.
Just one more time, in the 2 minutes that we have left, I'd like you to give us the who, what, where, when, how, and why for the Veterans Patriots Action Conference.
Sure, it's veterans.
And also for those that can't attend, is there anything that they can do?
Absolutely. Go to the Embassy Suites, be it tomorrow and Friday, or just Friday, or just Thursday for that matter.
Mm-hmm.
VeteransConference.com is where you need to go on a URL to find out more information. It's at the Embassy Suites in Charleston. There's only one Embassy Suites in Charleston. Show up. They'll be glad to sign you up when you get there. Doesn't matter if you're there for half a day, 2 days. Lieutenant General Tom McInerney is going to talk about American at Risk, dismantling our nation, which is currently what Obama is doing, diplomacy, information, military, and the economy. And the introduction to combat arms, the integration of combat arms by Jude Eden, former U.S. Marine Corps.
By the way, was a guest with us yesterday.
Who Jude was?
Yes, she was.
Oh, incredible lady.
Yeah.
She's got the story.
Is there, for veterans that can't make it, is this going to be a teleconference or anything?
That I do not know, but there'll be plenty of coverage on it on the Special Operations Speaks website, which is www.specialoperationsspeaks.com. All together, count the yeses, make sure there's four S's, or just Google Special Operations Speaks and you'll find us.
Lieutenant Colonel Dennis Behaney, U.S. Air Force, retired. Once again, I want to thank you so much for your service to our country and the service you continue to give our country. Once again, please give out those websites.
Yes, sir. VeteransConference.com, specifically for this Veterans Conference, and SpecialOperationsSpeaks.com. Each of those will get you to VPEC. One directly and one will pop up and immediately show you where VPEC is. Just get on there, go to Charleston, the Embassy Suites location is there, the address, and sign up, check in, sign up, and enjoy 2 days of really good patriotic sort of activity.
Well, number one, as I said, and I sincerely mean, Charleston's my favorite city.
And
we all have to stand behind our veterans. Veterans and people who have not had the privilege of being a veteran, but we need to get behind our veterans. And again, Lieutenant Colonel Haney, I want to thank you so much for your service to our country. Please say hello to our friends down there like Jude and also Admiral Lyons. And when you see Roger, tell him hello for us, okay?
You bet. And anytime you want Roger and I on to talk Benghazi, please sign us up.
Will do.
Okay.
Thank you so much for joining us on Conservative Commandos. Take care. God bless.
Thank you both. Bye-bye.
You are listening to Conservative Commandos with George Landreth and Rick Trader, coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network at WNJC 1360 and around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM/FM 24/7. Don't go away. On the other side, George and I will be speaking with our next guest, David French. Be right back.
You see, I'm crazy. I really don't care. That's my prerogative. They say I'm nasty, but
You've heard Paul Delks playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. He is also an experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485-904.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Boswell's Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS for automation.com. That's PCS, the number four, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Tuesday, February 23rd, the historic Nevada caucus to select the president. You can make history even bigger. Sign the citizen initiatives that will take Nevada in the right direction. First, the Voter ID initiative to protect your vote in November. Currently, anyone without identification can vote in Nevada elections. Second, the Pupil Privacy Protection Initiative to secure the data that is collected on children at school so that it cannot be released without the parents' permission. And third, the Healthcare Freedom Protection Initiative. It's time voters had a chance to end the failed Obamacare exchange in Nevada. One signature on each of these will make this historic day in Nevada even bigger. Sign these initiatives right at the door on your way into the Nevada caucus on Tuesday, the 23rd. Join Sharon Angle and Our Voice Pack. Visit OurVoicePack.com to read the initiatives. It's time to make this happen with your help.
Paid for by Our Voice Nevada PAC, not affiliated with any candidate or candidates committee.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Schrader, the Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show. This is George Landreth and Rick Schrader. And if you would like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, you can do that first by checking out our websites at CCRSnetwork.com and CCRShow.com. In the mornings at 9 a.m., you can log on to LeadingEdgeRadioNetwork.com. At 1 p.m., you can log in to Roar Radio Net. And at 9 p.m., you can log on to HighPlainsDailyNews.com. And you can always listen to the Conservative Commandos from any phone by calling 832-999-1199. Well, as promised, we're back, and we have David French with us. He's a staff writer at the National Review. He's also an attorney practicing predominantly in the area of constitutional law and armed conflict. He's a veteran of the of Operation Iraqi Freedom, and he was the author or co-author of a variety of good books. The most recent one is a number one New York Times best-selling, Rise of ISIS, The Threat We Cannot Ignore. He is a graduate of Harvard Law School. He's the past president of the Foundation for Individual Rights in Education and a former lecturer at Cornell Law School. David, welcome to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
Thanks so much for having me.
Absolutely. Now, we of course, with the unfortunate and ill-timed passing of Justice Antonin Scalia, now have this potential political battle to fill that seat or that place on the court. There's lots of talk going on. Yesterday we got a lecture, not terribly accurate in terms of constitutionally speaking, not a surprise, from the president, telling us what the Constitution seems to require. His understanding of it says that, you know, what he believes it requires. I thought it was interesting. So let's have a talk about the facts. Let's give our listeners a chance to get a real sense of what's going on. You've written a great article, "The Future of the GOP Hangs in the Balance in the Coming Supreme Court Fight." I think that you perhaps understate the case, because it seems to me that it's more than the future of the GOP. It's actually, I would argue, the future of our republic. If the court goes, you know, full gonzo in the Elena Kagan Sotomayor, you know, realm of just approving whatever crazy stuff the president wants to do, and the Constitution no longer matters, we can win whatever elections we want in the future. The court will effectively stop the idea of limited government and always come down on the side of bigger and bigger government, and effectively end representative democracy in America. At least that's how I see it. But let's talk about your take on the future of the GOP and just in general what's really at what's at stake.
Well, it's pretty simple. I mean, I don't think it's a news to anybody that there are enormous strains in the conservative coalition right now. You know, that there would be no Donald Trump candidacy, or if it was a candidacy, it'd be an afterthought if there weren't enormous strains. If you look at the top two national poll, the top two vote-getters so far are Donald Trump and Ted Cruz. Both of them have run specifically against the GOP establishment. Even the quote-unquote establishment choice, which is Marco Rubio, who's getting more, who's polled better than any of the other candidates aside from Cruz and Trump, he's a guy who got his start as an anti-establishment candidate, beating Charlie Crist in Florida, and is seen as the original Tea Party senator. So right now, the GOP establishment is on the ropes with the conservative grassroots. And if the establishment were to then say, okay, well, here's what we're going to do. Before presidential election, indeed, while the election, the primary is going on, we're going to hand control of one entire branch of government to the left without putting up a fight, that would be, I think, the final break in the coalition. Because the last argument that the GOP establishment in Washington has been able to make effectively for its own existence and effectiveness is that at least they've been able to say no and have been able to stop many of the Obama's worst excesses. They've been able to stop cap and trade. They've been able to stop they've been able to stop legislative amnesty. They've been able to stop a number of things. But if they can't stop this nominee, then they're going to lose that last kind of justification for their existence, and at that point it will be a true meltdown.
Yeah, now you make a very good point. Certainly the grassroots, we have plenty of things that we're frustrated and angry with the Senate over. I agree with you, that's what's given us Donald Trump. I think in a world in which the U.S. Senate or the U.S. House have performed better, I agree with you that a Trump candidacy isn't really possible. But in a world in which we're essentially beside ourselves with kind of the ineffectiveness we've seen in the last several years, other than, I think you're right, stopping some truly bad stuff, but in many cases failing to accomplish some of the things that seemed like they were gettable. So as a result, I agree with you that what happens is if the GOP Senate majority folds on this one, it will be almost indefensible, and there'll be almost no way to argue, yeah, but we really do need the Republican Party. At some point, it'll just be, no, we don't. What we need is a conservative party. The Republican Party is obviously largely a relic of the past, and we need to start over. I would argue that in some respects it's even worse than that. As I said, I think that the nation is at risk if we go that route, simply because the president will definitely appoint someone who will help him destroy the Constitution. So, you know, once that happens, we're done. It doesn't matter how the elections turn out after that. We could win elections for a life, you know, a generation, and still have a court overruling them constantly. How do you see this playing out? Do you see the Senate hanging tough, or do you see them slowly picking off a few people here and there to get down?
That's a great question. Let me put it like this. For now, I see them hanging tough, but I wouldn't be shocked if they capitulated. We've already seen Tom Tillis out of North Carolina indicate that he's wavering. There's some questions whether Chuck Grassley's intentions are. I think you're going to see some people wavering. Now, here's the thing. I mean, the reality is that Mitch McConnell, whatever you think of Mitch McConnell, he's an absolute genius as a parliamentarian. And so it's entirely possible that he can maneuver this to where he actually prevents the nominee coming up for a vote, even as some members of the Senate, of the Republican Senate, break with him to try to save their own races or save their own seats. But for right now, I think that they're going to stand firm. Now, it does not mean that they would deny a hearing to a nominee. I would expect that they would grant a hearing to a nominee. They may even grant a vote to the nominee. But I expect them to stand firm on not confirming an Obama appointee, an Obama nominee, in the middle of an election. And the other thing to remember is the clock here is on the GOP's side. With every day that it gets closer to the election, the logic of putting someone on the court now starts to diminish, because by the time the summer rolls around, we're going to be dealing with a situation where we're going to be in the party conventions. General election will be heated up. I mean, there's a lot of there will be a strong argument at that point. Let's just wait a little while longer and get some clarity.
Yeah, that makes sense. David, we've got to take a quick break. Can you stick around for the next segment?
Yes.
Excellent. We appreciate that, because we have some more things to talk with you. This has been very interesting, but we will be right back after these messages. We're coming to you live from the Conservative Commandos Radio Network Studios, WNJC 1360, our flagship station, and around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, Talk Stream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, and AM FM 24/7. We will be right back.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vyden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassford, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
Why will you be required to show photo ID at the Nevada caucus on February 23rd? To protect the integrity of your vote. Why will nobody be required to show photo ID on November 4th when we pick a president? Because it's the law. You can change this. When you go to the Nevada caucus on Tuesday, February 23rd, sign the Voter ID Initiative at the door. It's simply wrong that your vote can be disenfranchised by anyone without a photo ID on Election Day. Sign the Voter ID Initiative now. Vote for it in November. You can protect your vote with one signature on your way to vote for the president on February 23rd. Security is one of the prime topics this year, so why not secure your vote with one signature? Sign the Voter ID Initiative to be sure your vote counts. The single best way to stop voter fraud is to sign the Voter ID Initiative. One signature starts the process to protect your vote forever in Nevada. Join Sharon Angle and Our Voice Pack. Visit OurVoicePack.com to read the initiative. Let's change this and bring real integrity back to elections.
Paid for by Our Voice Nevada PAC, not affiliated with any candidate or candidates committee.
You can call the Conservative Commandos radio show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando radio show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos radio show with George Landreth and Rick Trader. And for rebroadcasts of our shows, check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or mornings at 9 a.m., log on to leadingedgeradionetwork.com, at 1 p.m., roarradio.net, or at 9 p.m., highplainsdailynews.com, or you could hear our show by calling 832-999-1199. Our guest this segment is David French. He's a staff writer at National Review. And we're talking about an article that he has written, The Future of the GOP Hangs in the Balance in the Coming Supreme Court Fight. David, thanks for holding through that break. We appreciate your time.
Not a problem.
David, I think you make a great point here and ask a pretty interesting question. Assuming the president picks a Hispanic, African-American, or Asian-American, bonus points if she's a woman, this could be exactly what Democrats need to reactivate the Obama coalition. Now, you also point out in your article the Obama coalition, that is the low-information voters that will turn out in equal numbers. Now, are you saying that that you see the Obama coalition as the low-information voter? And if so, does the low-information voter really know or care about the Supreme Court?
Well, the Obama coalition is the combination of the hardcore progressive base and a much larger group of people who tend to be more low-information voters, who came out to the polls because they felt, a personal connection to President Obama, were motivated by him, moved by him. Mm-hmm. That's how Obama won in 2012 when Romney, of course, won Republicans and Romney won independents, but he still lost the election because Obama was able to mobilize this base that combined mm-hmm. a hardcore base and then a large number of people who hadn't voted before, who were occasional voters. And the case I'm making is Supreme Court nomination fights do not pull out anyone other than the base.
Right.
They do not reach the low information voters. I mean, let's look at facts.
Right.
When Antonin Scalia passed, he was one of the longest serving members of the Supreme Court, and he was one of the most controversial. Yet one third of Americans didn't even know who he was.
Mm-hmm.
They had no clue who he was. That's an amazing statistic, and it tells you something about
how judicial nomination battles play out in the larger culture. So if the Democrats think that they can recreate the Obama coalition, which included the base, their highly informed base, and also included all those many millions of lower information, less engaged voters over a Supreme Court nomination, I think that's just fundamentally wrong-headed thinking.
Well, David, so my next question to you would be, who would the Republicans be afraid of, the Obama coalition or the media, who is bound to trash any move the Republican or the Republican Senate would make in stopping an Obama nomination to the Supreme Court?
Well, I mean, look, the media is going to trash the Republicans now between now and the election anyway. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, that's just going to happen nonstop. I mean, they're going to try to find ways to stoke racial identity politics, to stoke grievances. I mean, look, in 2004, I don't know if you guys remember this, but in 04, the NAACP ran an ad that simulated an African-American man being dragged to death from this terrible dragging death that occurred in Texas, with a person saying that when George Bush didn't sign hate crimes legislation in Texas, it was like her brother was dragged to death all over again. I mean, so look, they will seize on anything to try to drive up the vote and drive up turnout. So what I'm saying is that of all the things that they could seize on, whether or not a particular Yale-educated lawyer or Harvard-educated lawyer ends up on the Supreme Court of the United States is not going to be terribly much more motivating than many other things that they'll try.
You know, David, I wanted to bring both you and George in on this because when Scalia was confirmed, by a 98-0 vote. And one of the two votes that he didn't get was Barry Goldwater because Barry Goldwater was sick at the time. So, David and George, you could make the argument that we're playing on a different field than we were 30 years ago when Scalia was confirmed. That politics is a different animal. Would you say so, George?
I think so. I think you've seen it change pretty significantly, really, since Robert Bork's nomination. And what you have now is a process that is simply about, we don't like your guy. Miguel Estrada, who was appointed to the D.C. Circuit, or not appointed, but nominated, went over 2 years and never got a hearing. From the democratically elected, from the democratically controlled Senate. This was Bush's nominee. He was, by all accounts, a conservative, but couldn't even get a hearing. So it's not a real argument to suggest that somehow the Democrats can argue that Republicans must give a hearing and a vote. And yet that's the argument they will make. It's the argument the New York Times will make. It's an argument the New York Times argued against when Bush was president and said that the Senate did not have to hold hearings, did not have to give them a vote, but they will now make the exact opposite argument because, quite frankly, they are lying sacks of feces. But that's just how it works.
George, you want to pick it up from here?
Pardon me?
Do you have another question for David?
Oh, absolutely. Yes, I do. David, you've in your article pointed out that the Republicans will be hailed for their, quote, integrity, unquote, and their courage, unquote, as they begin to question whether or not this upcoming nominee should get a vote or a positive vote. I think you're right about that. Do you think that would be a powerful enough poll to pull people over? Because I would argue that conservatives have to make it clear to anybody who crosses that line that that is the Rubicon and they will never be reelected. There's nothing that
that's exactly right. Unless conservatives make that clear, we're going to see people cross that line. I mean, we know from history that that occurs, and we know from history, in particular, when you're talking about elected officials who are truly, by the time maybe their second, third, fourth term in the Senate, they're more Washington D.C. residents than they are residents of their home states, and so the social, political and cultural pull that is exerted through the Northeastern media is incredibly strong on these folks. And so we've seen many times where Republicans will break ranks with fellow Republicans and be hailed in the media, praised as independent thinkers, and that has worked in the past. So, however, there has been some improvement on that score in recent years. I mean, let's not forget that Obamacare, for example, was passed only over the unanimous objection of the Republican caucuses in the Senate and the House. So there has been a little bit more unity in recent years, maybe than in some of the years past. But we have to remain vigilant. I mean, when you already have Tom Tillis saying we don't want to be seen as obstructionist, then, you know, and that's only after about 2 or 3 days of media criticism, you know that we're going to have to maintain visibility on this issue, because it will be simply disastrous if Republicans swung control of one branch of government over to the left so soon before presidential election. Look, if the Democrats win the presidency, they're likely going to win the Senate as well, because the calendar this year is just rough for Republicans. So unless the top of the ticket can really help out the candidates down ticket, it could get kind of rough. But that's all the reason, all the more reason why. Let's wait and see what happens in November.
Absolutely. Well, David, this is a great article. I appreciate the work that you do at National Review. To tell our readers, we're going to take a break and conclude, but tell readers how they can follow what you do.
Very easy. I write every day on nationalreview.com, and you can follow me on Twitter at David A. French.
Very good. Thank you, David. Thanks for being with us, and thanks for the good work that you do, both in your public policy work and at National Review. We need more people like you.
Thanks so much for having me. I appreciate it, guys.
Absolutely. We, of course, are the Conservative Commandos. We're coming to you live from the Conservative Commandos Radio Network Studios, WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia. And, of course, for those of you not in Philadelphia, we're coming to you around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, and AM/FM 24/7. We will be right back after these messages. Don't go away.
You've heard Paul Delps playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. He is also an experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485-904.
Owner of Boswell's Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time, without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS for automation.com. That's PCS, the number four, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Tuesday, February 23rd, the historic Nevada caucus to select the president. You can make history even bigger. Sign the citizen initiatives that will take Nevada in the right direction. First, the voter ID initiative to protect your vote in November. Currently, anyone without identification can vote in Nevada elections. Second, the Pupil Privacy Protection Initiative to secure the data that is collected on children at school so that it cannot be released without the parents' permission. And third, the Healthcare Freedom Protection Initiative. It's time voters had a chance to end the failed Obamacare exchange in Nevada. One signature on each of these will make this historic day in Nevada even bigger. Sign these initiatives right at the door on your way into the Nevada caucus on Tuesday, the 23rd. Join Sharon Angle and Our Voice Pack. Visit OurVoicePack.com to read the initiatives. It's time to make this happen with your help.
Paid for by Our Voice Nevada Pack, not affiliated with any candidate or candidates committee.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with George Landreth and Rick Trader, coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, WNJC 1360 in Philadelphia, and around the world on the internet. And George, we do have our next guest with us. Will you please make the introduction?
Sounds good. I will. I had my microphone on mute there. My apologies.
That's all right. It happens.
I was doing the introduction, and then I heard you cut in. I realized, oops, my mic must still be on mute. Well, we have Jeff Dunitz. He's an editor. He's the editor and publisher of The Lid and a weekly political columnist for the Jewish Star and Truth Revolt. He's also contributed to Breitbart, Hot Air, PJ Media's Tatler, and Jeff is also a blogger for mcrtv.org. The Media Research Center does great work on monitoring the media and all that sort of stuff, and Jeff's involved with that. He's also co-host of Fomenting Freedom on SHR Media. So, Jeff, welcome to the Conservative Commando.
Thank you. Hey, if I can just chime in with where your last guest left off for a second.
Yes.
If the Republicans cave in, there is no longer a Republican Party.
Yeah, I agree with that. There isn't really much of a republic yet either. We'll just be governed by the Supreme Court.
You bet.
Democracy will
cease. Second Amendment.
The elections will cease to matter at that point.
Rights. Right. You're right.
So, you've written a really good article. It's entitled Hypocritical Democrats, which I think is somewhat redundant, but I will let that pass as an editor. that phrase, it's like, you know, hot water heater. It's like hypocritical Democrat. Come on. But I'm sorry, I don't mean to nitpick, because you actually are an excellent writer, so I'm just making a point to make a point, so to speak. But anyhow, hypocritical Democrats demanding GOP allow a vote on Scalia's replacement. Let's talk about what the Constitution requires, what they say it requires. We had the president yesterday lecturing us about what his view of the Supreme Court process is. It's interesting that it's now radically different than it was just a few short years ago when he was filibustering Supreme Court nominees that he himself said were justified, well-qualified, but he opposed them anyhow. So let's have that conversation. You've written a great article, which, by the way, can be found at mcrtv.org.
Yeah, mrctv.org. But the Constitution says the president has to nominate somebody and the Senate gets to advise and consent. Well, not voting on somebody is an indication of they're not consenting. So Obama's right. He has to nominate somebody, but the Senate can block it. You know, right. And there's the same thing.
Hearings are not required is your point. And I think that's important.
They don't have to say yes.
Treaties have the exact same provision that they're, you know, advising consent of the Senate, and it is not at all unusual for the Senate to object to a treaty by simply refusing to have hearings and vote on it.
Absolutely. You know, and actually what set me off on this search was Chuck Schumer was on ABC's This Week, and he mentioned that the Democrats never did this, that he voted 97... that they voted 97-0 for Justice Kennedy in the last year of Reagan's term, which is true. However, before they got Kennedy, they absolutely destroyed a good man in Robert Bork. They said no on Bork, and then the next guy had a little marijuana problem, and then they went to Justice Kennedy.
And in fairness, his marijuana problem wasn't that he was a current user. It's that he had allegedly used it in the past.
Right. You know, and judging by some of the things that comes out of the left side of the court, I think they're all imbibing, but that's a different story. You know, I still remember...
Would that were only marijuana.
Yeah, right? But, you know, Ken Kennedy, Robert Bork was basically Scalia before Scalia. I mean, even though Scalia was already on the court by then, you know, he really started with originalism. And Kennedy started talking about 45 minutes after Reagan nominated him. Kennedy got up and said, you know, in his America, women are forced into back alley abortions. There are segregated lunch counters, rogue police would break down. I mean, nonsense. And he's basically this guy who had already driven a poor girl off a bridge and killed her and had already contacted the Soviet Union telling them not to listen to President Reagan, destroyed this man's life, basically. So that kind of got me off to looking at other things. Like, for example...
Right. It is an interesting thing that he forgets to mention that we now have a verb that is a former nominee's last name. The verb is to bork, you know, and it is a verb that means, to, you know, essentially to treat unfairly, to lie about, to malign, and to ultimately refuse. This is a fellow who'd been on the D.C. circuit and had never been overturned.
Never.
So, I mean, he was not an extremist, because if he were, the court would have said, whoa, you can't be doing that, and they'd have overturned him. His reasoning and his logic and his opinions were impeccably reasoned and supported by the text of the Constitution and, of course, the laws that he was reviewing.
Well, that's because the left does have a problem with the Constitution.
Right. Yeah, they view it as an impediment to good government, not the standard by which good government is to be judged.
Or something. Well, it's, and I had this discussion the other day, it's really the way they look at it. They look at the Bill of Rights as something government gave the people. But really, our founders and us believe
further limits on
what
government.
God gave the people, and the Bill of Rights just wrote it down.
Absolutely, that's true as well. They believe, they totally understood that God was the grantor of rights. But my point is it's written, Congress shall not do this, Congress shall not do that. In other words, it was a limit on government. It wasn't even actually, they didn't even pretend they were granting you rights. They were just simply saying government can't do this. And
they weren't saying government, they were saying the federal government.
Right, that's exactly right.
Because the whole separation of church and state thing, when the Constitution was approved, every state had a state religion.
Right.
So they don't get it.
Right. This is the interesting thing, I guess. Let's look just at history real quick. Have the Democrats tried to filibuster a Supreme Court nominee in the last decade or two?
Well, how about 2006, when everybody tried to
so that would be the last time a Republican nominated somebody,
right? And it was Durbin who's still there, Hillary Clinton, who's been whining this week when she wasn't barking, Biden, Harry Reid, and this junior senator from Illinois at the time, Barack Obama. He said that I think Judge Alito is somebody who is contrary to the core American values, not just liberal values.
Well, they also did agree that he was qualified. They just didn't like his judicial his viewpoint on things. Jeff, we've got to take a quick break. Would it be okay? I want to get you to explore what you just started more deeply. But can you stay over for the next segment?
Excellent. I sure can.
I appreciate that. We will be coming right back to you. We're going to take a quick break. You're listening to the Conservative Commandos radio show. And, of course, we're coming to you live from the Conservative Commandos Radio Network studios, WNJC 1360, which is our flagship station in Philadelphia, and we are coming to you around the globe on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, and AMFM 24/7. Don't go away. We will be right back with Jeff and more talk about the Supreme Court.
The Conservative Commandos radio show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos radio network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos radio network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
This is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
Why will you be required to show photo ID at the Nevada caucus on February 23rd? To protect the integrity of your vote. Why will nobody be required to show photo ID on November 4th when we pick a president? Because it's the law. You can change this. When you go to the Nevada caucus on Tuesday, February 23rd, sign the voter ID initiative at the door. It's simply wrong that your vote can be disenfranchised by anyone without a photo ID on Election Day. Sign the voter ID initiative now. Vote for it in November. You can protect your vote with one signature on your way to vote for the president on February 23rd. Security is one of the prime topics this year, so why not secure your vote with one signature? Sign the voter ID initiative to be sure your vote counts. The single best way to stop voter fraud is to sign the voter ID initiative. One signature starts the process to protect your vote forever in Nevada. Join Sharon Angle and Our Voice Pack. Visit OurVoicePack.com to read the initiative. Let's change this and bring real integrity back to elections.
Paid for by Our Voice Nevada PAC, not affiliated with any candidate or candidates committee.
You can call the Conservative Commandos radio show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando radio show.
Welcome back. This is the Conservative Commandos. I'm George Landreth, the co-host, and the host is Rick Trader. We, of course, are coming back to you after a quick break. We are with Jeff Dunnitz, who is our guest and knowledgeable expert on all things Supreme Court. But if you would like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our websites at ccrsnetwork.com and ccrshow.com. And in the mornings at 9 a.m., you can log on to leadingedgeradionetwork.com, and at 1 p.m., you can log on to roarradio.net. And at 9 p.m., you can log on to highplainsdailynews.com. And you can always tune in and listen to the Conservative Commandos from any phone by calling 832-999-1199. Now, Jeff, before the clock forced me to rudely interrupt you, you were telling us a little bit about what happened in 2006. I had asked you last time the Republicans were nominating someone to the Supreme Court was George Bush, and what happened, and did they they ran the Senate at the time, and what was their approach initially?
They tried to filibuster it, including our present president. Now, here's the fun part, okay? This will make you laugh. At today's daily press briefing, Josh Not-So-Earnest, the president's spokesman, he said that the president regrets trying to filibuster Alito.
Okay? Now he does.
Okay. He says, but it didn't matter anyway because the filibuster didn't go through. It's kind of like when he threatened to filibuster a debt limit hike and then argued that you can't filibuster against the debt limit. If the Democrats didn't change their stands, they'd be sitting or something, because that's all they do. Interestingly enough, in the same year that Reagan was trying to get Bork and then, you know, the threesome through, the New York Times ran an editorial and said, you know, elections matter, but midterm elections matter also. and the Democrats won the Senate in 1986. So they should be able to stop Reagan's or not confirm Reagan's nominees.
For once, I agree with the New York Times.
What?
For once, I agree with the New York Times.
Yeah, but they're gonna deny it now.
I'll deny it now.
Guy Benson actually tweeted that a little while ago, and it kind of made me laugh.
There's a couple things I think are interesting. I'm sorry?
Say that again?
Well, there's a couple things that I think are interesting about this whole debate.
Okay.
One is the president deserves his guy. And I think that argument has a certain level, not entirely, because you still have advice and consent, even with cabinet members, but it's a little more compelling with cabinet members. So the example would be, I could see you having a different standard for who should be the attorney general. Because after all, the president did win the election, and he has he has to have a team, and he's entitled to have a team that's part of, you know, his orbit of issues and so forth. And you have obviously the obligation to do advise and consent, but one could argue at least that that's one sort of standard. But he's not entitled to his judges. That's a separate branch of government, and they're not part of his team. Under the Constitution, they actually, through separation of powers and divided powers, perform a different function. They're not part of his team, so he's not entitled to his guys. And so as a result, it seemed to me that when the president's approving or submitting a name for a judge, he's actually not entitled to any presumption that they need to pass him. Would you agree with that, or do you think I'm misstating?
Well, no, you're right, but in the end, you know, with that and with the whole, and, you know, in the article I should have a lot of examples of the hypocrisy, none of it matters. Let me tell you what matters. What matters is the Second Amendment. What matters is freedom of religion. What matters is destroying any of the gains we've made in preventing abortion. If Obama gets to appoint his own people, that's what happens. Okay, this year, the Texas law that made sure that you had to have the abortion doctors had to have hospital rights, that's going to be a 4-4 tie this year because Scalia died. That might be revoted on next year. Okay, with a liberal judge, it gets thrown out. The Obamacare, remember the Hobby Lobby case? Well, this year what's coming up is something a little different. It's whether or not the religious organizations have to sign the form that says the insurance companies can go buy the insurance. Now, to the people of faith, that's saying by signing that form, they're actually endorsing contraceptives. This is the, and I laugh at their name, but this is the Little Sisters of the Poor case.
Okay?
Okay? This, if we allow Obama to replace Scalia with another liberal judge, okay, organizations like the Little Sisters of the Poor that do so much good work for people will have to close down because they won't break their religious vows. They won't break their faith. That's what this is all about. So beyond the hypocrisy, beyond the pressure, beyond all that, what this is all about is whether this country will remain the free country that our founders envisioned. Whether, you know, I always laugh at the progressives because they believe that they might go to church or synagogue, but once you leave the grounds, then religion is over. While we know that religion is something you're supposed to live by. Okay, whether you're allowed to live by that religion. You know, in San Francisco 2 years ago, they tried to outlaw circumcision. I'm Jewish. That's an important right.
I think it's amazing. I think it's argument before. And I don't understand.
You know, George, let me jump in here because all of a sudden your line went real bad, and I'll take over from here, George. George, call us back in, okay? Here on the Conservative Commandos radio show, we're speaking with Jeff Dunitz. He is the publisher of The Lid. He's also we're discussing his article that's posted on mrctv.org right now, Hypocritical Democrats Demanding GOP Allow Vote on Scalia as a Replacement. Jeff, as you and George were speaking here, I'm perusing, and already there are signs that the GOP is signaling that they're going to confirm whoever Obama wants. And I wanted to see if you are also seeing the same thing.
You mean the fact that there have been a couple of people who have taken step away?
I'm sorry, repeat that, please.
You're talking about people like Ron Johnson and things like that?
I'm opening the article right now. And because my internet is a little slow, Senate GOP signal it will confirm whoever Obama wants on the Supreme Court. And this is from Red State. And they're talking about Charles Grassley and...
Chuck Grassley, all he said is that he will hold hearings. He did not say he will... And that he suspects that whoever Obama sends down won't get confirmed.
Okay. And, George, are you back with us?
Yes, sir, I am.
Oh, that's better.
One thing that's important, I think, for folks to understand, if the Senate wants to hold hearings, that's fine. I don't even care. They don't have to. There's no requirement they hold them. But if they want to hold hearings, that's fine. And if they want to hold a vote, they can. That's fine. But I tell you this, the vote better be no.
You bet.
The Republican Party will have no excuse for existing, and I would argue more importantly than the Republican Party, our representative democracy is officially died at the very moment that Justice Scalia passed away. Because it will not matter what happens at elections in the future. You will have a court that will rule us, and they will impose liberalism upon us and cram it down our throats sideways.
If the GOP establishment doesn't want Trump to be elected, let them give in to Obama, because if people were angry before, they're going to be much angrier after.
Well, Jeff, one of the things that concerns me is when you listen to what Trump, you know, the next president is probably going to be able to nominate from 2 to 4 members of the Supreme Court when you look at the age of the remaining Supreme Court justices. Okay, a couple of them are in their 80s, I do believe, or close to it. And
I'm in the 70s and a couple in the 60s.
Right, and as recently as last summer, he was talking about how his sister, a liberal lawyer who is a judge, would make a terrific Supreme Court justice, and she has, I can't find the article right in front of me, but she has supported Planned Parenthood and abortion in the past. So if this was an indication of who Donald Trump thinks would make an excellent Supreme Court justice, I mean, we're in trouble.
Well,
if he's elected,
get me started, because my inbox is already filled with hate mail from the Trump people. Donald Trump is a liberal, okay? He has changed his party affiliation, get this, 5 times since 1987. Okay, he does it as the wind blows or at what's politically expedient. And if you ask me, the conservative things he's saying right now, he's saying because, you know what, he wants to be president. He wants to be the biggest bully in the world. I do not, you know, I haven't decided who I'm supporting, but I can tell you right now, the 3 people I'm not supporting, well, 4 if you include Bush, are Clinton, Sanders, and Trump.
Mm-hmm.
What happens after that, I haven't decided yet.
Well, Jeff, you and I are pretty much in the same boat, except for I at this time am in the Cruz camp. But, you know, I'm asked every day by people on Facebook that if Trump gets the nominee and he's running against Clinton, Sanders, or I'll throw in Joe Biden, who am I going to vote for? And George and I were talking about this earlier in the day, and I can't see myself voting for Clinton. I can't see myself voting for Sanders or Biden. So who am I left with, really, if he becomes the nominee? But at the same time, I look at, you know, Jeff, I listen to this man now. I have not heard him say anything positive about anything or anyone. I've not heard him talking about his vision for America. All I hear him doing is trashing everybody else. It's like he wants the biggest building in town. Instead of taking bricks and mortar and making his taller, he's going at everybody else with a sledgehammer. But he did, you know, he talks about we're going to make America great again. To me, it sounds like a whole bunch of hope and change all over again. But he doesn't talk about how he's going to make America great again, except for building a wall and making the Mexicans pay for it, which won't happen.
In fairness, I think it's not fair to say he's never said anything nice about anybody, because he did say something nice about Vladimir Putin after Vladimir Putin said something nice about him. So,
and he did say his daughter was hot.
That's true, and that's right, he said his daughter. I mean, my concern is that he's not a serious grown-up, because serious grown-ups do not have their reaction to other people be based solely on what they say about him. You hear him. If he talks about the other candidates, if they said something nice about them, then he likes them. If someone asks him what he thinks of Putin, if Putin's most recent statement is nice about him, he likes Putin. This is like three-year-old stuff. This is immature. There's something phenomenally scary about having a three-year-old.
Hey, George, I hate to cut you off, but we have about 30 seconds left, and I wanted to give Jeff an opportunity to tell our audience how they could follow his work.
Guys, if you go to leadtheblog.com, four or five posts there every day, 5 days a week at MRC TV. And by the way, you mentioned Cruz. Did you hear about his press conference today? He basically told Trump, so go ahead, sue me. But then you're going to have to do a deposition. Mm-hmm. I have the video and wrote all about it. It's the lead story on my site right now.
Jeff Dennett, I want to thank you so much for joining us. And by the way, we are affiliated with, as you are, with SHR Media. When is your radio show?
My show is Mondays at 2 p.m.
Mondays at 2 p.m. Fermenting Freedom.
Yes. And our guest next week is Jim Garrity.
All right. Jeff Dunnitz, thanks for joining us. You take care. God bless.
You too. Bye-bye.
George, I want to thank you for sitting in today as my co-host. Got to make a quick break. So here's the sign-off. Got to run, got to go. Take care. God bless. See you tomorrow on the radio.